Hello, my name is Karen Russell, and the title of my final project is The Era of Jazz. What is jazz? Jazz is defined as a type of music of Black American origin characterized by improvisation, syncopation, and usually a regular or forceful rhythm emerging at the beginning of the 20th century. Brass and woodwind instruments and piano are particularly associated with jazz, although guitar and occasionally violin are also used. Styles include Dixieland, swing, bebop, and free jazz. The Smithsonian National Museum of American History, Kenneth Barron Center members help us define what is jazz. Take a look at this short video clip as they discuss.
Jazz is like love. It's something we recognize when we encounter it. It's very hard to define. It's fun to hear. It's complex. It's creative. It's inspiring. It's basically a life force.
Well, it's always moving forward. It isn't music of the past. It's music of today. It's music of the future.
Jazz came out of the African American community experience, and much of that is based on the Black church. Call and response is an active component of praise and worship. You know, the leader speaks, and then the audience responds. The person who's taking a solo makes a musical statement. Someone might respond to that statement. So it becomes an actual conversation that's going on. It's a conversation. One of the hallmarks of jazz is improvisation. And so you're responding to lots of things, ideas that you have in your head, things that you know, things that are coming at you in a millisecond. You would really want to lose yourself in the music, and you don't know what's coming out of you. But the only thing that's coming out of you is what's inside of you.
The origins of jazz can be traced back to the African, as seen in African music, African dance, and even African dress. In the 1600s, as the American slave trade began, the African slaves brought with them their music traditions, which in many ways served as a means of communication in the New World. While slaves were prohibited from their traditional drumming, they kept their language and music alive with singing, stomping, clapping, and even dancing. They often performed these musical art forms for their masters at plantation events, creating the beginning of the transformation and transition of jazz throughout all cultures, as will be seen in the late 1920s into the 1930s and on until today's music. African American jazz culture has an amazing influence upon popular cultures in the 1920s due to the availability of these recordings to white, upper middle class listeners, a new jazz culture. Jazz music influenced all aspects of society. Jazz it up, the 1920s. The jazz age was a period in the 1920s and the 1930s in which jazz music and dance styles rapidly gained nationwide popularity in the United States. Originated in New Orleans as a fusion and predominantly African and some European influences of jazz quickly permeated into all facets of American music. The 1920s brought artists such as Jelly Roll Morton, Django Reinhardt, Cliff Edwards, Buddy Rich, Jimmy Rodgers, and Huddy Ledbetter. Names that may not be widely known, but individuals who laid the foundation for jazz and modern music. Though not as large in numbers, many women helped pioneer the early jazz movement. Some female jazz artists celebrated success as well. Bessie Smith, who was portrayed by rapper, actor, entertainer Queen Latifah in HBO's 2015 film entitled Bessie, helped propel women into jazz and jazz into the spotlight as the music of its time. The jazz centers of the 1920s. Jazz began as social gatherings among Black musicians in New Orleans. They would congregate to improvise and share their music in places such as Storyville, a red light district in New Orleans. These early jazz musicians called this and similar places in New Orleans their home. Because of those places, they could do music their own way. Chicago and New York in the 1920s held great opportunities for musicians. Gangsters such as Al Capone owned and managed the cabaret and dance clubs, which often allowed jazz acts of all races to perform. The New Orleans sound spread throughout Chicago's South Side in places like the Plantation, the Nest, and the Sunset. The jazz played in Chicago evolved into its own unique style, but was still referred to as New Orleans jazz. The New York jazz music was influenced by ragtime music, which had been popular in the early 1900s. Scott Joplin had played in New York, and other great musicians followed in his footsteps. After the original Dixieland jazz band played on Broadway, jazz musicians imitated the New Orleans sound. How has jazz influenced modern music? Jazz's influence on the world music scene would be nothing short of transformational. Jazz can rightly be called the people's music because it is heavily influenced by the surrounding social situations where it is played. It takes today's social issue and weaves a tune around them. Jazz is where musicians strive to preserve the genre's heritage even as they seek to innovate. Rock, R&B, rap, hip-hop, and country take its cue from jazz. Jazz gave me the blues. Rhythm and blues, known as R&B, is used to refer to music styles that develop and incorporated for jazz. It consists of a standard 12-bar blues chorus with its familiar harmonic structure and narrative form. The first two official blues songs were named Dallas Blues and Memphis Blues in 1912. Wrap it up, jazz and hip hop. Jazz has been a great source of creativeness in hip hop. Whether borrowing from the sound and feel of jazz or sampling of great tunes and catalogs, hip hop artists have frequently felt a great affinity with the jazz tradition. Jazz, a rock and roll legend. In the year 1950, rock music was developed, and on its premature stages, it was characterized as blues, country, and jazz with electric guitar. In later years, it was generally portrayed as hard-edged music played with electric guitars, drums, bass, and lyrics sung by vocalists. Jazz and country music. The country and western music of rural towns merged with the swing of the big bands of urban jazz. Western swing marked the transition from the archaic string bands to the dance hall orchestras. These bands were responsible for the introduction to country music of instruments such as drum, horns, and electric guitar. Some famous jazz musicians: Louis Armstrong, Duke Ellington, Miles Davis, Dizzy Gillespie, Billie Holiday, Ella Fitzgerald, Nat King Cole, and Frank Sinatra. Jazz and theater, Porgy and Bess. Porgy and Bess is often considered the U.S.'s first great opera. The song Summertime, written by George Gershwin and featured in this legendary work, was remastered by two of jazz's most well-known artists, Louis Armstrong and Ella Fitzgerald. Take a brief listen to how jazz allows you to feel the emotions of the song through instruments and lyrics. Relax and let the jazz tell your story. Thank you. Karen Russell, and this concludes my presentation on the era of jazz.